Blackstone presents Wrecked, a Faye Longchamp mystery by Mariana Evans. This book is read by Cassandra Campbell. For my sister Suzanne. Prologue. The drone flew like a bird, cutting through sea breezes as if it could feel the joy of a living creature. Sometimes it flew high, though not so high as to lose sight of the Florida Panhandle's battered coastline. Sometimes the drone dove like an eagle, and its camera got a close look at colorful fish swimming in water as clear as air. The fish fluttered through the wrecks of newly sunken boats. Perhaps they remembered the hurricane as they swam below sea craft still able to float. Perhaps they didn't. The drone didn't care. It just snapped their picture and moved on. The drone's camera captured everything in sight. Clean water, broken trees, littered sand, swimming fish, flying birds, and shattered houses. Because that is what cameras are made to do. They record everything they see. There is no hiding from them. When the drone was flying low, its camera caught the faces of exhausted people spreading blue tarpaulins over splintered roofs. It saw the sun-bleached hair of people on pleasure boats, rubbernecking at destruction. It saw the bobbing heads of swimmers brave enough to share the water with floating wreckage. The camera captured light reflected from the silvery backs of sharks and barracudas who swam wherever they pleased. When the drone was flying high, it captured the contours of the coastline in the fractured light of sun on floodwater and broken glass. It saw the enormity of what the hurricane had done. What is more, the camera's images were stamped with a date and time, and over time, the images recorded the movements of each boat. A careful observer could look at the drone's images and guess where all the boats and swimmers had been and where they might be going next. If the drone made multiple flights that day, and it did, all of its pictures together gave a sense of the passage of time. The drone knew when the highway running along the Gulf of Mexico had seen heavy traffic that day. It noticed that the same boat had sat here in the morning and there in the afternoon, moving someplace else in the evening before cruising home. With a drone and a bit of ingenuity, an enterprising person could find fishing spots that had been family secrets for generations. Almost everything captured by the camera was inconsequential, a series of instantaneous incidents that would be forgotten by morning. But not everything. The drone saw a place that had been the home of people long dead, generations of them. Barely visible, the stone outcropping marking its location had been exposed by the scouring waters of a hurricane after years and years under the seabed. But that wasn't all. Someone was taking things that belonged to someone else, hoping to get rich. Someone was stealing something irreplaceable. The drone saw it all. Chapter 1. Chainsaws roared. Voices chanted, 1, 2, 3, as clusters of people lifted chunks of trees too heavy for one person to lift alone. Neighbors cried, thank you so much, as one driveway after another was cleared. Short and skinny, Faye Longchamp Mantooth was struggling to do her part in carrying the big logs. She had friends who were sleeping in tents where their houses used to be, and she knew how much they would suffer under the broiling July sun. She had begged them to come stay with her, but there were looters prowling Mico County, and they were terrified. They'd rather live outdoors with the mosquitoes than lose the very few possessions that the hurricane had left behind. She struggled to think of ways to help them, fill their ice chests, swap out their propane tanks, bring them food and water. But these things weren't enough. Nothing was enough. Not really. Faye recognized the peculiar clarity of the sunlight that shines in the aftermath of a hurricane, because she had seen it before. It was as if swirling winds had drawn the moisture right out of the air, leaving nothing but oxygen, nitrogen, and traces of the usual stray gases. She felt as if she could see forever through the clear air, or at least to the point where the earth curved and hid itself. And everywhere she looked, she saw something that the hurricane had crushed.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.